The third flow that we look at is waste. This includes different types of products or consumer goods that enter a household and that, sooner or later, leave the household again as waste or to be reused elsewhere. As we saw before, there are limited ways in which water and energy enter the household. The inflows are mainly connected to centralized networks. For products, this is different. There is no underground network to send products to a household. Instead, we usually bring them home from different shops by car, bike, or walking, or by post or home delivery. There are also large differences in how long different products stay present at a household. Food, for example, could be consumed within hours, while clothes may stay for several years and furniture even longer. Sooner or later, products may break, or we may not need them or like them anymore, and they become waste. When waste leaves a household, there may be different ways to transport and treat it. In the Dutch case, waste may be collected in bins or bags and picked up by a municipal company once per week. In other areas, there may be collective containers that are regularly emptied. Within this diverse system, food holds a special position. There is a constant inflow and outflow of food that stays for a relatively short period of time within the household. Some food requires dedicated storage, fridges and freezers for storage, which consume energy. And once the food is eaten and digested, it leaves the household via a specific installation, toilets and the sewage system. As the product and household waste system is diverse, it also offers very diverse sets of opportunities for optimization. Food waste may be avoided by planning groceries well and making soup from leftovers. Green waste in gardens may be composted and used as fertilizer. Broken products can maybe be repaired and used again. Clothes may be sold or donated so that others can use them. As we saw before, making the energy and water system of a household more circular may require different types of appliances and installations. On the level of products, however, and household waste, a shift towards circularity has much more to do with behavior and decisions that we take every day. If the members of a household are aware that anything that they buy will one day become waste, and if they try to always rather repair or donate something than discard it, then they can strive to become a more circular household.